Hachette Audio presents Our Broken America, Why Both Sides Need to Stop Ranting and Start Listening. Written by Jackie Gingrich Cushman, with a foreword by Newt Gingrich. Read by Sabina Brendel. To my husband Jimmy and our children Maggie and Robert, I am so grateful for you three. Without you, I would be adrift in a sea of nothingness. You are my anchor and safe harbor.
This is Newt Gingrich reading the foreword for my daughter Jackie Cushman's new book, Our Broken America, Why Both Sides Need to Stop Ranting and Start Listening. This is a book with a powerful message of hope for American renewal and an amazing number of specific examples and insights. It is a serious contribution to the conversation we must have if we're to bring our country back together again. I'm proud of the citizen that my daughter, Jackie Cushman, has become, and I am most proud of the time and energy she and her husband, Jimmy Cushman, have put into their two children, Maggie, now a sophomore at Davidson College, and Robert, now the senior class president at his high school. It has been fascinating to watch Jackie study and learn as her children went through the various stages of childhood and adolescence, and are now emerging as solid, thoughtful, and admirable young adults. It was by talking with Jackie over the years about the different ways Maggie and Robert deal with life that I began to realize just how constantly she learns and how many different places she goes to for information. She was constantly bringing up the newest thinking about childhood or education or grappling with the challenges of life. About 15 years ago, Jackie began writing columns. Her thoughtful approach to writing columns carried her from personal topics, such as remembering her mother, to insights into the raising of children, to education, to religious liberty, to the lessons of history and current events. During that period, she also wrote two books. The one we wrote together, Five Principles for a Successful Life, From Our Family to Yours, is as relevant today as when we collaborated on it more than a decade ago. It was while Jackie was thinking through the current tensions, hostility, and bitterness that are splitting the country that she began to develop an important notion. She determined that persuading Americans to take personal responsibility for emphasizing the positive was the key to getting America out of its current decline into vicious, unrelenting political partisanship. Jackie's insights into the importance of being positive and her ability to cite psychological studies on the upward spiral of energy, confidence, and cooperation versus the downward spiral of hostility, alienation, and gridlock create a significant framework for getting America back on a positive track. Both Democrats and Republicans would profit from reading Jackie's analysis. The current infighting has real negative consequences for the future of America, and even small positive steps could build a reinforcing cycle of accomplishment. In some ways, Jackie represents a revival of a deeply American positivism, which grew from Benjamin Franklin, Abraham Lincoln, the two Roosevelts, and Ronald Reagan. Historically, Americans have held a deep belief that the future will be better, that we can help make the future better, and that the key was, in Dr. Norman Vincent Peale's best-selling phrase, the power of positive thinking. It's no accident that the Trump family routinely attended services at Dr. Peale's church and learned the importance of having faith in a better future while working to make it come true. This combination of optimism about the future and a willingness to work, both as individuals and involuntarily formed collaborations, was a key part of Alexis de Tocqueville's analysis in his 1835 classic, Democracy in America. Jackie has had the great advantage of living what she is recommending. She and her husband Jimmy have a deep commitment to the Atlanta community. Jimmy has served on the boards of the Atlanta Botanical Garden, the Atlanta History Center, and the Arts Alliance. They've supported Our House, which provides shelter for homeless children and their families so they can live, learn, and thrive. Jackie and Jimmy have also supported activities at Pace Academy, the school their children attended. Every time I chat with them, Jackie and Jimmy have a civic engagement underway. They're also deeply involved in their church, where Jimmy serves in the vestry. Jackie also serves as the CFA Society Atlanta Foundation, which focuses on financial literacy, the Trust for Public Land Advisory Council, and the Georgia Early Education Alliance for Ready Students, which focuses on learning for children from birth to the age of 5. Jackie is also an avid tennis player, and Atlanta has the largest tennis association in the United States. I mention all those activities so you will understand that when she advocates local involvement and local citizenship, she is living what she's preaching. Jackie's belief that local volunteerism is better than national bureaucracy is a restatement of the classic American position. She understands Friedrich Hayek's principle, expressed in his classic work, The Road to Serfdom, that a centrally planned and implemented system inevitably involves the massive loss of freedom. She has absorbed George Orwell's warning that a totalitarian system must inevitably eliminate individuality and coercively force obedience to the whims of the central system. This warning that socialism and left-wing totalitarianism are both roads to loss of freedom is timely. We have a younger generation that has not learned the lessons of history. We have a news media that does not want to describe the lessons of Venezuela, Cuba, Zimbabwe, and other economic failures pulled down by failed socialist ideas. Jackie is combining the lessons of American history, the warnings of great economists and writers, and just plain common sense. What makes me especially interested in this book is Jackie's clarity that the long-range future is not conservative centralism versus left-wing centralism. Any centralism is inherently dangerous. In this approach, Jackie is exactly in the tradition of the Founding Fathers. She cites example after example of the great leaders who believed in freedom and understood that defending liberty required courage and a deep sense of personal responsibility. Finally, this book is so inherently American. As the author of The Essential American, 25 Documents and Speeches Every American Should Own, Jackie is especially well prepared to emphasize the core values and history that have made America an exceptional nation. She understands that the Founding Fathers created a system of exceptional freedom designed to protect liberty from the human propensity to slide into dictatorship of one form or another. She correctly emphasizes that the belief that our rights come from God and not from the state is what makes America exceptional. For virtually all of human history, rights have come from those with power, whether a chieftain, a dictator, a king, or whatever form upon which power was centered. The generation that wrote the Declaration of Independence knew from their study of history that human institutions tended to decay, that power was corrupting, and that the powerful operated out of self-interest rather than patriotism. That founding generation believed its duty was to design a machine that could prevent tyranny. In 1776, in the Declaration of Independence, they first established that we owed our rights to God, not government. They insisted that we had been guaranteed life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness by that God. In 1787, in the Constitution, they established the machinery of government, which has lasted for 232 years. This machinery was deliberately made so inefficient that no would-be dictator could force it to work. In fact, the founders did such a good job of creating inefficiency by sharing power among different institutions that we can barely get it to work voluntarily. American exceptionalism comes from this focus on individual liberty and God-given rights. It has allowed more people from more countries with extraordinarily diverse backgrounds and cultures to come together in the pursuit of happiness. Jackie understands that this remarkable achievement is under attack and that saving it requires a cultural response more than a political response. It requires personal responsibility more than government responsibility. This is an important, timely book that offers hope and practical suggestions in a period of hostility, divisiveness, and tribalism. After you read the book, tell your friends and those concerned about the survival of America about it, and continue this essential conversation.
Introduction. Who I am, why I care, why you should too. I am tired of the politically polarized environment of America. How about you? This environment is being enabled by politicians, news organizations, social media, and even my friends and family. I am not alone. According to an Associated Press NORC Center for Public Affairs research poll, over half of Americans believe the political polarization of the nation is extremely or very threatening. And another 30.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.